Hello, this is Dr. David Kreller of the Department of Chemistry of Georgia Southern University with another video tutorial. This one is about dilutions, and I'm really going to just make one fundamental important point in this video. First, we'll ask, what is a dilution? When you hear the word dilution, it could have two meanings. You could use dilution as to refer to a process that you carry out, like a set of steps to accomplish something. Or you could say a dilution is the material or solution that has been weakened or diluted. You could say the process of dilution creates a solution that has been diluted. Let's just work through a very, very simple example. Say you've got a solution, 1 mole per liter in the potassium permanganate, and you have 1 liter of it, or 1,000 mil equivalently. Okay, then you transfer 5 mil of this solution to a 500 mil volumetric flask, which you then make up to the mark. And then you mix well to make sure it's a homogeneous solution that you've just created. And you ask yourself, what's the concentration of this new solution that you just created? Well, how do you approach that? How do you think about that? Well, I'm just going to make one simple point here, that the best way to think about this is to keep track of the number of moles or mass, basically the amount of the solute that you transferred from the first solution to the second solution. Now, I'm going to use some very simple equations in a minute here with numbers to keep track of, you know, concentrations and volume. So I've also really good practice is to like really keep track of the solutions. Call the first solution number 1, the second solution number 2, so that when you number concentrations and volumes, you know exactly which solutions you're talking about. Okay, so you track the amount of the solute that's been transferred, and that's basically the KMnO4, the potassium permanganate, that's being transferred from the first solution to the second solution. Now, why would you think that's important? Why would you think it's important to track the total number of moles that got transferred? The reason being is that the moles of potassium permanganate that you transfer is going to control the number of moles of that solute that are in the new solution. And that's going to be very important. So to figure out the number of moles that you've transferred, take molarity 1, molarity of the first solution, times V1. Now here's a problem. Here's a point of potential confusion. Which volume do you use for V1? Do you use the volume of the entire solution, or do you use just the volume that's been transferred? Well, obviously, you should just use the volume that has been transferred, because you're keeping track of how many moles of that solute have been placed in the second flask, and you only transferred 5 mil, you know, so only the moles that were in the 5 mil transferred really count, really ended up in here. It's really ridiculous to think that you should try to use 1 liter as the volume transferred. Okay, so you multiply molarity of that first solution times the volume of this first solution that's been transferred. Multiply those together, you get 0.005 moles. And that's the number of moles of the solute that are in the new solution, which, of course, we've labeled solution number 2. And so the key point is, it seems like an obvious point now, that the moles of KMnO4 that have been transferred equals the moles of KMnO4 in solution 2. Really, this should be more specific. Moles transferred equals the moles in solution 2. And that leads naturally to this equation, which may look familiar. M1 times V1, where, again, don't forget that V is the volume that's been transferred, equals M2 times V2. Now, V2 can be the total volume of that solution that's been created. But basically, that's where that solution comes from, because the moles that have been transferred equals the moles that are present in the second solution. Okay, now the question is, like, we're not all the way there, but we really, when we have this understanding, we're good part of the way there. And if we keep this in mind, this keeping track of the amount of the solute is important. If we keep that in mind, that's going to lead us to the solutions of all the dilution problems you could ever run into. So what's M2? So basically, you just take this equation and rearrange it and solve. Or you could say, okay, so you end up with 0.01 moles per liter. And if you're clever and keeping track of this, the concentrated solution here was 1 mole per liter. Now, the diluted solution that you've just created is 1/100th of a mole per liter. Well, that's it's been weakened by a certain factor, which you could calculate that factor as a dilution factor and just put 5 over 500, put those volumes, solve it that way. That's fine, that's absolutely perfect, but just keep in mind that now you should have no confusion whatsoever as to where this equation comes from. Okay, just a quick little video. Hope that's helped somebody.